Welcome back to the workshop. Well, by the title card, you can tell exactly what this is. This is Salvino's JR Models brand new 2022 Chevrolet Camaro ZL1, the next gen race cars in the Chase Elliott Napa Auto Parts livery. This is a brand new kit. This kit is so new that it was just molded in California a couple days ago and was sent out so that I can show you guys everything that's in the box. Now, don't worry, this will not end with just an unboxing. This is the next kit that I am building. But the day it arrived, I'm super excited. It is so cool. I knew you'd all want to see an unboxing of it, so you can get your pre-orders in at modelroundup.com and snag one for yourself, because I think these are going to sell out the second they hit the general market. This thing is awesome. It's fully designed by Jim, Rick, and Chris over at Salvino's JR. It's an all-new kit, complete new design. They've worked with NASCAR. Look at the stuff that's going to be coming out for the new race cars. We got Chase Elliott in my hand. Alex Bowman, Kyle Larson, William Byron. Yeah, I mean, they've got some big names and other stuff coming out. There'll also be other manufacturers, but let's get through the Napa Hendrick Motorsports car first before we start talking about other things. Now, this kit is molded in multiple colors. So for you beginners out there, if you want to get into stock car modeling, you can build this model and make it look extremely close to the box art without throwing a drop of paint at it. That's right, without throwing a drop of paint at it. I'm gonna do this a little different than other unboxings in that I'm gonna pause between each set of colors so we can reset the table and we can take a look at those. Right now, I'm gonna get the first color out and I'll be right back. The first color of styrene in the box that I'm going to let you look at are the white sprues. The white styrene molded in that night. It's almost a grayish white, which would be correct for the car. Now, they have studied these all the way down. So if you build this, it's going to look the right way without having to spray paint everything. We'll get in close and I'll let you take a look at all the trees from both sides. I love how prominent the numbers are on the trees. Everything is called out well. The connection points are nice and thin. The detail on the parts is extremely crisp. Look, no flash hiding inside there. I'm not going to try to identify all the parts unless I know what they are, and even then I'll probably make a mistake. We got our center tunnel there on the flip side. Check out all the detail. At the end of the video, I will have a picture-by-picture release of all of these trees as well. Excellent detail. The other white tree, there is only one other white tree. We got our fuel tank, more of our interior pieces. Look at that webbing and cross members. Look at the attachment points. That is just so nice. Look at that large interior piece. We got roll cage, driver protection areas, sheet metal. They paint them that whitish gray in real life. Loving all the big attachment points where you can see things where they'd be in real life or how they would join together. Nice crisp fuel tank on the flip side. So I'm looking forward to building this bad boy. I'm going to be starting on it. Like I said, I've got a kit video done already for Saturday. This is Thursday in April, but I will be coming back with the next color. Next trees are the metallic trees. So this upcoming Saturday will be a new build, and this will be the build right after it. Look at that. I think those are like fuel rails on the engine. Check out that intake and carburation. Look at the molding on that. Modern molding, modern mold designing. Boy, Jim has been working overtime at Salvino's JR Models. My Lord, this is the first time I'm seeing this in this form. I've seen some previews like the public has, but this is my first time really going through all the parts trees, all the little bits and bobs. I am so impressed. I have high standards for modern kits. I let a lot of stuff slide on older kits, but not modern ones. Look at the shocks. The struts. That is unbelievable. Turn that tree around. Get that parts in there. Look at the detail. Those must be suspension arms. That is crazy. Much more than you assemble on the older stock car kits that they release, even on their own designed 1/25th scale kits. This is mega expanded. All, I mean, the whole box was stuffed right to the top. The second tree, just as impressive. I think the entire model is going to be insanely impressive. I put my hand behind here only to allow digital cameras to focus easier. I mean, steering, look at that steering, black wash inside there, and you are all set. I mean, check that out. That is just so, oh, look at the brakes. Give me a break on the brakes. Look at these housings. Wow. The headers are just begging for a black wash, and they're perfect. And that they molded this in color and took ideas and said, let's make this so that a raw beginner to modeling can not only put this kit together, but get it to look extremely like the real thing without having to throw paint at it is just awesome. So there's the two silver trees. One, two. I'm going to reset for the next color and we'll be right back. Next up is the black parts trees. We've got two of those molded in. We got our pedals, we got our window net, we got our radiator fan, we got our inner fenders. It's even got inner fenders molded in another color. Ooh. And those wheels are so nice and open. You're going to see that awesome brake work back there. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Outstanding. Really, really. I know this is such a big deal for Salvino's JR to get this out and get it out as fast as they did. And even with minor delays, wow. Look at that belly pan and diffuser. Never used to see that on stock cars, but they're getting smart. Aerodynamics. Just, and this is all molded styrene. It's not resin. It's not full of flash, slide molding, new designs, all this different duct work and body parts. Don't worry, we'll flip the tree over. They're numbering them like they do in the modern kits from Europe and Asia. We got that driver's seat. It's the top of the roll pan. Lines and hoses. Magnifique. Magnifique. I'm so proud of these guys to get this out. There's our two trees in black. And we will reset for the final colored styrene. Last but not least, the blue colored styrene for the body. Got our hood. Got our clip there. Flip that over. The camera's going to lighten up the blue. It is a darker blue in person. It's very, very, very close to the blue on the box. A direct match to the Napa colors there. When we apply a clear coat to this, or as I will do future floor polish, it will darken that up. It'll still appear lighter on a camera. But it is a dark blue, correct with that. In real life, it's showing up like that image. But on the camera, the plastic, for some reason, always shows up lighter. But it actually is the same color. It's one of those, is the dress gold or blue things. And that beautiful Camaro. The Camaro is a sexy car. And this really helps out. Check out the bottom there. I mean, this isn't a snap kit body adapted to be a kit for a race car. This is all new. All amazing. Look at the roof line on that, with the escape hatch, the anti-roll flaps, little antenna bumps. I think those are antenna bumps. Trunk lid. Wow. Those are the blue parts with that awesome Camaro body, so we're not even going to have to paint the body on this one. I'm going to go over to the other side of the table and grab the clear styrene and some other stuff. In this section, we'll look at the clear styrene, which is super, barely shows up on camera, super clear. We've got spoiler. We've got back glass with the correct amount of those ribs in it. Ribbed for your pleasure. Got the door glass. Look at the they call them, I think, NACA ducts, N-A-C-A ducts in the rear windows. And it's not just imprinted, it's completely molded in 3D. And they're molded open. They're molded open. I'm dumbstruck, awestruck, gobsmacked at what a modern kit can be. That is our beautiful clear parts tree. Take care of that. Then we've got four really sweet tires. And the best thing about these tires is they're molded. I don't even have to sand those. They've got that rough texture in them, rounded sidewalls, solid all the way through. Just cut that little nib off where they were removed from the rubber mold, and you don't have to do anything to those tires but apply the decals. Those are, I mean, I don't even see a mold line down the center. Not on that one. That one's got a little bit of one. That one doesn't have one. So that's it. So a little bit of sanding on that one tire. And we are ready to go. We are all set to go. So speaking of decals, I will be back with the paperwork in just a second. Okay, the decals kind of blew my mind. So first, let's look at the manual. Then we get to go to those. They've done a new style manual. They're not using any of the old monogram style directions. They've got a beautiful decal call out on the front. They've got numerous notes on assembly. Decal number one goes, decal number two goes. Hit notes if using white body decals, apply before them. Ooh, we got white body decals. I snuck that out. Wheels, dark gunmetal, chassis, very light gray. Body, PMS, reflex, blue. BBS decals are added, one per wheel. All that kind of stuff on there. Officially licensed by GM, Hendrick Motorsports, NASCAR. They've got all that awesome stuff on there. We'll go inside. They give you some ideas on assembly. They will tell you the order. They'll tell you color codes if you decide to paint it. They haven't left out the paint, people, but they're just making it a lot easier. That is absolutely awesome. We'll just look at the whole manual, page for page, so you can pause it, plan out your build, plan out your painting if you choose to do so. It is a fold-out map style. Got the next section there. It's a transaxle. They give you the proper names because Chris doesn't know all the proper names. But you can learn while you're building yours. Oh, just going to go frame by frame. Pause it at any time. We're going to flip it over there. This is an extensive kit to assemble. This is not a 20 minutes and you're all done gluing. But I'm going to see how little I can paint on mine on this one. When I build another one, we'll go ahead, we'll throw some paint at different stuff. But I'm going to see what we can do with just some black washes and stuff like that. Because you can make a black wash at home. Right there. Oh, so awesome. Just love going through this. I saw in tracking it was on its way out. So that's the entire map folding. And I was so excited. Now, we've got one, two, three entire decal sheets. I'm going to get those ready and be right back. First up, the Napa decals. If you plan on painting the body, these will definitely be ones you'll be using. Well, you're going to be using these either way. But yeah, these are the ones made by Power Slide for Salvino's JR. I can't believe we're actually getting to see the newest stock cars in a time when they're actually running on the track back at like we did in the old days. Look at those tire decals with the black lines, the blue for around the rear windows, that gorgeous Napa yellow. Yes, so extensive, beautifully done. They've got the gauges on there for the dashboard. We'll bring that out. You can pause the video and check those out. The next out of the three is for doing all the black work. We're talking around the glass. We're talking the Camaro logos. We're looking at our headlights and grill. We're looking at even the lower grill is done for you. We'll just scan that by real slow. Got our lower body decals, look at the 3D taillights. Nice. Freeze frame on that. And then finally, if you don't plan on painting the body at all, they include, we'll have to hold this funny because of the lighting, it's white on light blue. They include the white decals to surround the bottom part of the body with decals. So you take that blue body that we had over here, you apply all the white decals first. You can see like this area here is covered by that decal right there. Sort of tell where they start going around. And once you get done, you will have trimmed the bottom of the body in white decals, and then you can start applying your yellow and racer decals over the top of that. So we're gonna give that a shot. It's gonna take quite a while, but I've got time. We'll go on there, we'll warm them up, we'll use decal solvent to hold them down, and we'll do that on camera so that you guys can see how to work on those. And that is all the parts in the Chase Elliott 2022 Chevy Camaro ZL1 from Hendrick Motorsports of the next gen Camaros being run in NASCAR right this weekend. You can watch this video and watch the next stock car race and see this car. That is what is so awesome about this, is that they produced it during the era that it's being made in and it's being run in, which is what we used to see back in the day when they re-release all those other cars, and this is in 124th, like the old monogram ones. When they release all the other 124th old monogram stock cars and all that, those cars were produced in the day that we were seeing them race. You could buy Dale Earnhardt's car, you could build Dale Earnhardt's car the weekend you saw him race. So that is what has me so excited about these. I'm going to have those still images at the end of this video. I thank modelroundup.com, Salvino's JR, for cooperating to get me this kit immediately right after it was printed. When I say right after it's printed, smell it. Get it up. Go. Smell that plastic. It still smells like the factory. It still smells like it just came out of the injection mold. That's how new this kit is, and that's why I'm so excited. So I will have those still images of the decals of all these body parts at the end of this video, and I will see all of you at the next review.
Thank you.
After that marathon build session, which in real time took about 3.5 hours, somewhere around there, since I'm not familiar with the kit. I haven't built a bunch of these before, so I didn't just fly through it like I do a normal glue kit that I'm familiar with. We've got what you see here in front of you, and I have to say that, as you saw on camera, it goes together very well. I mean, you see me drop some parts. It was a part on the engine I put on backwards, which I was easily able to turn around. Other than that, the directions are clear. They let you see where it goes together, and everything fits very well. I did have very minor complications going through in that my chassis pan was warped, and that's pretty common with a thin piece of plastic over such a large surface area where the front is very thin and the back has all this complex shapery to it that you will end up with a warp. But that was no worry because, as you saw, the chassis itself glues to the roll cage, and that roll cage and the chassis parts key into the bottom of that chassis plate in those 6 points, and in the 7th point where the differential attaches on the back, the transaxle, so it all straightens itself out. If you need to, if yours is warped when you put these chassis parts on, just clamp it for a little bit. Mine was warped right underneath where it went underneath the roll cage, which meant when I held it together with the model glue and then clamped it for 20 minutes, it just straightened itself out and it sits perfectly flat, as you can see now. Very nice detail in here. Since I'm not painting this one, I'm building it right from the box. I went through and assembled everything so that we can take a look at it through that long building session. You can see those gorgeous brakes on there, the full suspension going together. They've got bumpers, they've got air inlets, they've got air inlets over the engine, they've got the full scoop for the radiator in there. They've got all the different brackets and braces that hold the bumpers in. They've even got the fuel and vent lines and backflow lines. I mean, they've really thought of it all. The interior's got the fire extinguishers, the petty bars, the extra braces, the steering wheel, the nice little digital dashboard, the huge rear pan, and look at that, without any cutting or filling. Look at that. Pretty much seamless going through there. I mean, that you don't see stuff that fits a lot like that. So, one thing I had with fit, and it really isn't a big deal because it's easily curable, was the tires. The inner wheel tends to pop out quite easily when we start putting it on the car. And the wheels don't fit very tightly on the hub, and when you start to slide them together during final assemblies, they want to kind of push apart when you push them together. So what I will do, and they do fit kind of loose on there to give us that center lug nut look, but that is not an issue. While that will be solved, I will again push out the wheel. I will apply a little bit of rubber cement on the inside, a thin film, push the wheel back in, and our problem, in quotes, is solved. And then we will be able to get those onto those hubs without them wanting to push apart when we push them in tight. But the car sits on all four. That is a sweet looking wheel and tire package. So if you had to whine about something, and I'm sure there will be people that find things to nitpick about, but if you're just building this kit, you're not going to really have an issue. In the directions, there are some minor mistakes. Now, they have provided an addendum to go with the instructions, and I've got that over on the side here. They already recognized that there were a couple small mistakes where parts were mislabeled or not labeled at all. So they tell you where to get those correct part numbers listed. In step one, C12 and C13 should read G12 and G13. This will be in your instructions. And there's a couple other areas that I'm not going to go over that do have an incorrect part number listed. I didn't write them down. I didn't scribe it down because the instructions are so clear on what part you're using that when there is a minor mistake on the listing of a part somewhere, if it says like D88 and it should be D89, I'm not saying that's the issue. I'm just saying when there's an issue like that, there absolutely is no problem. When this says like D20, and I think it ended up being like D21, I think that was where one of them was. There's nothing you're going to mistake on the instruction sheet for this part, and that's kind of where a minor mistake will be made. So don't worry about it. These instructions are so clear, like I showed, that you can just spot the part and know exactly where to put it and what to put it, and you're not going to have a problem. So that's what I have to talk about for building it. It goes together quite nicely. The glass drops in. I use Mod Podge to put the glass in. We'll get the hood out. I let that dry overnight. I am not putting really any paint on it except for what I can do with like a marker really quick, such as using a black Sharpie to accent the braces on the glass front and back. I used a black Sharpie to color in the clear spoiler where the brace is, or you have the option of using the solid spoiler if you're on a track, if you want to build a car from a track with a shorter spoiler. But since the one on the box art has the clear spoiler in the back, that's how I went with it and that's how I did it. I used a silver Sharpie to highlight the bottoms of these wings along the back of the body like they are on the box art again. They got a metallic mount and then you can fit it onto the vehicle. Otherwise, I use Mod Podge to attach everything. When we go ahead and apply our clear coat, any little clear areas you see around the paint where the Mod Podge has made the plastic look a little more shinier, when we go and I put my future floor polish over the, all the decals and the glass and everything, that's all going to blend in seamlessly. You'll never notice it again. The glass fits in absolutely gorgeous. We don't have an issue with it. Just drops right in. Take your X-Acto knife and clean up the edges when you cut all those nubs from the tree, and every single piece is going to drop in just the way it should. You're not going to have any problems. Also, I already test fit the chassis to the body. We can even do it on camera. There's little holes where it fits in that I'm going to have to super glue it in the front. You can see those. But that's it. I mean, it's in. It's tight. It looks awesome. That was body fitment. There's your whole body fitment. Right there, you can see that bottom of that chassis lines up perfectly with the body. Done. Boy, that was difficult, wasn't it? You had to fight with it. So we're just going to have to put a little bit of, see where those little pins are? See that little pin sticking down underneath that vent there? That's what we'll need to put a little bit of super glue on, and then I'll have to clamp that up because my piece came a little warpaged. But you can see that it fits in perfectly. Once we clamp it, it's going to go in. That's it. That's all we really have to talk about. So I don't even need to have the body on the chassis to start doing my decals. I'm going to get the white decals out. How I start those out is I get a dish of warm tap water. That dish that we'll see in the video has one drop of dish soap in it to just lubricate the water and the decals a little bit. You can use any decal solvent you want on those decals. They are pretty durable. I currently am going through, I test them all out, going through a bottle of Mr. Mark. You can use Tamiya, you can use Microset, Microsol, you can use Testers, I don't care what you use. So use whatever you want, and you'll be seeing how I'm going to apply these white decals so that we get our white on the bottom of the body, and then I'm going to let those dry overnight. So when I come back, we're going to be set up, we're going to be sliding decals on.
Thank you.
And there we have it. After just 2 days, mostly just letting decals dry on the outside before I moved on to the next level, we are done with the very first Salvino's JR Next Gen Camaro model released. This is an absolute beauty. I can't believe how well it went together. Final assembly, you saw how easy that chassis goes into the body earlier in the video. As predicted, on the very nose piece, that air dam down there, to get the body to sit level, I did need to super glue that into place. But other than that, the kit goes together very well. Since I don't plan on removing my wheels after my glamour shots at the end, I also will super glue the wheels on because they do fit quite loose, but that allows you to set things up and adjust it. This is the bone stock ride height that it sits at. You could adjust that by moving the suspension arms, as the manual tells you, to use pennies to adjust your ride height and positions to exactly where you want your car to sit. I just set mine up as they lined up with the chassis, and that made that go together quite well. The decals all lay down nicely. My white decals, I did not do the best of removing all the bubbles underneath them. There are areas where you can see some crinkles and some bubbles, but when you start laying the Napa decals and the grill and the headlights and all that stuff over the top, it covers up most of my boo-boos and any other boo-boos that I had where I kind of scratched it off or didn't get them to fit around the inside of the wheel wells perfectly because I didn't take enough time, because I build these quickly for videos. On your own video, or your own video, your own model making, you will have much more time than 2 short days to get that done, so you can actually spend the time heating those up and forming them around and getting them to go on much better than I did. But just in the quick amount of time that I did it, look how nice that is without using any paint to cover that white area, without any masking, without any special anything. We got that to look just like Chase Elliott's number 9 Napa car, which me, I've always loved the Napa livery. Now we've got it in the most recent cars you can see run on the racetrack, down to the little spoilers, the clear spoiler in the back, the new windows, and everything. You can get this thing to look just like a real race car without having to throw a bunch of paint at it, without having to do masking, without having to do any of that. You didn't see me do any of that. And on the shelf, this thing looks just like the real thing. Under the hood, in the chassis, underneath, you can decorate it any way you want. If you don't want to glue that air dam into place, you can also have it so that you can install and remove the body and set them next to each other when someone comes over to take a peek at it. You can pull the wheels and tires off, show them the brakes, show them the suspension. What an outstanding kit. I really enjoyed it. I was so glad that I got the Napa one first because I like that color scheme. And I don't have a lot of models on display in my house because I build so many. But this one's going to sit on display for quite a while before it gets removed for something else. Thanks to Model Roundup, they will have pre-orders ready for this kit. Thanks to Salvino's JR, Jim Rogers, Rick, Chris over there for working on this kit and getting it ready and producing it for the market. They sure knocked it out of the park for a very modern molding style and design that went together very well. Hope you enjoyed this video. I covered a lot of stuff for the first time builders in this, a lot of the building and the decals, which is going to be the things that intimidate a lot of people. And as you see, you can get yourself a very sweet looking model car with not a lot of work involved into it. Thank you all for watching. Appreciate the likes and the comments below. Share the video with your NASCAR friends. Share them with your modeling friends. Let them know that modeling can be easy, enjoyable, and you can get a nice looking vehicle without having to be an expert on kits. Thanks for watching the workshop. We'll see you all at the next review.